back to the point, slowly back to Cristoforo, an offering, saved by McPhee, and the rebound was right at the doorstep. There's another one. Good back check by Cummins. Knocks it away from McCarthy. More zone time. McCarthy got it back from in front again. McPhee robs Dwyer. Up in the slot. Stover. That's Fantonia blasting. It was a bouncing puck. Still loose. Wide open net. Curly Rice Lincoln. He scores! Daniel Lincoln with mass chaos in the crease. Is able to beat TJ Leno for the first time tonight. Knocked down by Jeremy Curley. In front, McPhee robs. I believe it was Curley coming in, and McPhee hanging on. McPhee robs Jeremy Curley. His temper's flare. Hurts the slot. Warwick gambled, and now here comes DeFonso. DeFonso in, save McPhee. Set out by Fantoni. Rebound to Colin Curley. And another save by McPhee. The Panthers. It's going to be Peckham. Peckham, a shot, score! Peckham scores as time expires. Peckham, Peckham, Peckham beats the buzzer. Shot score right off the bat. It's Jake Warwick, 13 seconds into the game. Well, how about that for a start? Thesis takes a tumble. If you couldn't tell, Plymouth South, and Sean Colbert shot score! 2 goals in 53 seconds. And here comes Lincoln. It can be a 2-on-1. Lincoln with Hayward riding shotgun. Lincoln and shot score! South into the attacking end, where they want to be. Hayward for Van Winkle, shot, score! Joey Van Winkle! 14 seconds later, Alex Hayward bided his time. Found Van Winkle, who let it rip. With a minute 39 to go, Canton comes all the way back from 3-0 down. They tie the game with less than 2 minutes to go in regulation. But Plymouth South, the cardiac kids. Hayward, good back check by Junta, but it's Sean Colbert now. Colbert in deep, scores! Minute 40 to go. Puck's in front. McPhee holding the far post. The puck is still loose. Body's flat around everywhere. Who knows where it is? It's finally cleared to the edge. Lincoln skates out with the puck in the neutral zone. Here comes Daniel Lincoln. He got tripped up a little bit. Lincoln puts it in on goal. Plymouth South is garden bound. And Lincoln is high stepping. And why not? Keep high stepping all the way to Boston, son. Plymouth South is garden bound. That puck on the net. That might have been before the clock struck zero. I don't know. Not that it matters. The Plymouth South Panthers, the cardiac kids throughout this entire tournament, put together a mighty fine 45 minutes of hockey, and they will state their case for the title a week from today at the TD Garden.
First of all, this team, it's all about heart, dedication, determination. But after our last game, and I saw everybody in those stands, that's not just our team, that's the whole school.
Difference at 30 seconds of time.
Somebody has just made that change this season.
Colbert, midpoint, there's a shot, score! 1-0, Joe Van Winkle! On the power play. You know what, Mr. Hall? That goal, the result of a quick trigger from the blue line.
Yeah, and that's the same Van Winkle that scored in the same way in that Canton game. The puck comes out to Van Winkle, and that puck didn't stay on his stick very long. Nice little one-timer through traffic, and he beats Barry.
Yeah, you see, in the white uniform, they turn it over, taken by Carroll, send it inside of the goal, left in front. Panthers, McPhee
got
a pat on it,
and
it's
no goal. Play may say otherwise, but the initial call on the ice is no goal.
Yeah, what a save by McPhee. Sprawling, just raw yelling. Greco was there, alertly there too, we might add. Puck was under there. I expected the whistle a little earlier than that. And then it doubled into the net. Good first period of play between these two teams in the Division II Championship. Shot scored from the blue line. Oh, wow. That was through a screen, and Warwick gets surprised. He startled Peter Barron. He was deep in his crease. I don't think he expected that. I don't think I expected that. Did you?
I'm not sure what your speech is going to be between periods. That puck just got through. There were a couple of guys in front of me and a couple of blue jerseys in front. Of Peter Barry, a hard time seeing that one again. Correct.
Gonna be pleased that he scored a goal and had to score. Beautiful play. Haywood just redirected it. That was designed to go that way. We're tied at 3 early on.
What a beautiful tip. You usually don't see tips like that. Saw a good zone entry here. Puck gets turned over. Slap pass to Haywood. Haywood was there alone to the side of the net. He leaped right out of that corner. What a great tip. Practice that stuff. Yeah.
Tony put it right on his tape, you didn't. Nice hockey title, and let's see if they can get a little help from up above and from Plymouth South. He's got a power play. So it'll be 5-on-4, so if they don't take a man away, they do play 5-on-5 hockey. But it's 5-on-4 because of the penalty for another 46. 146. Buckets on the right. Burke is going to steal it away, barreling in off the wing, cuts it in front of the net, the one-hander! McPhee saved from the rebound, ricocheted off a Warwick.
My goodness.
That's intercepted. Laid ahead by Burke. Barreling in, the shot, McPhee, the save on Carroll's opportunity. On the wall, Carroll diggling after it. Going to be taken away by Haywood. Haywood's going to push and chase. Carry down the left wing side. He's all alone. They're in the midst of a line change. And that went in. He shot it off the side of the net. And it went in off of Barry.
Unbelievable.
Alec Haywood.
That's the same way that Patrick Kane won the Stanley Cup in overtime. Throwing the puck on net. Stoneham is stunned. Plymouth South.
Wow. It looked so harmless. It actually probably hit the side of the net and may have careened off of Barry and in. Wow. What a stunner.
Unbelievable. What a game.
That's how Arlington won the D1A tournament a year ago, remember, with a shot that ricocheted off a skate from behind the net and in. Wow. Shocking. That was a game that neither team
deserve to lose. Heyward with his second goal. He threw it off the goaltender.
Wow.
And Plymouth South Panthers are first-time state champions.
They win by the score of 4-3 in overtime. What an exciting finish. Alec Heyward, the junior, scoring his second goal of the game. They're still consoling Peter Barry. But then they come in as the third seed, and they win this thing out of the South, beating Stoneham here today, 4-3 in overtime. Absolutely incredible. Incredible.
I'll tell you what, there's no coach more deserving than Mike McCosh, 21 years at Plymouth South. Heart and soul kind of guy, wears his emotions on his sleeve.
Last year they were the 13th seed. That's
correct.
Where the number 13
correct.
Seed
yep.
came
no, you're
from.
Absolutely right.
So that's quite an improvement from 13 to 3 to state champion. How's that? Gotta love it.
No.
He may not let the trophy go. That's what he meant.
He's got a death grip on that, and I don't blame
absolutely.
Him.
Absolutely. That's a lot of work for a lot of years, and it changes all the time due to graduation. So you have to build and rebuild, and come on, turn this way, boys. There you go. Give it to us. There you go. They're flipping them around now.
Their fans are on the other side.
Yeah.
Very classy. The Stoneham players staying on the ice to salute Plymouth South.
Yeah. Now they'll make their way off, give the championship team their just due here at the TD Garden. 4-3 in overtime.
Panthers there at Plymouth, of course, our eye-opener home away from home. Uh-huh. Boys hockey team recently won the school's first ever state title.
Congrats, and Mike Lynch will be featuring the guys in tonight's High Five on News Center 5 at 6.
The new Plymouth South High School opened its doors in late August. And by mid-March, the boys' hockey team made its contribution to the fresh trophy case by winning the Panthers' first ever state hockey championship.
What's life like around town and in school?
Crazy. Everyone's saying congrats and giving me pats on the back. It's awesome.
Awesome is a more than adequate term to describe the state final at the Garden. It was a thriller, back and forth with Stoneham. Each goal answered with another goal. There was great goaltending, and there was drama.
What I love most about this team is they just don't panic. This team just doesn't panic.
They didn't panic when they trailed 3-2 in the third period. They rallied and tied the game on an Alex Heyward goal. It stood at 3-3, headed to overtime.
Confident, just keep working hard. You know, at the end, even in the third period, we almost popped a couple or one or two, but went into overtime, we finished it.
Finish it they did, and in style, on another Heyward goal, giving the Panthers the title and setting off a celebration.
Well, I kind of looked over my shoulder, noticed no one was with me. I knew how to throw the puck to the net, get a line change, and went in.
I can't even describe the feeling. It was just celebration, you know? Amazing.
What was more amazing was the gesture moments later. Stoneham team member number 11, James Lutie, passed away in November, just prior to the start of the season. His presence was felt at the Garden, and his image was visible to all in attendance. In the midst of the post-game celebration, Plymouth South coach Mike McCosh walked into the Stoneham locker room and presented the game-winning puck to the Spartans captains and asked that it be given to James Lutie's parents.
I know that family's hurting, and I just want them to know that Plymouth South is with that family, definitely.
Champions with class as well as compassion. We salute the Panthers of Plymouth South, state champs, and this week's
High Five! Yeah!
Oh,
Well, you think about that. It's the moment of their life. They win a state championship. The coach, Mike McCosh, has been there 22 years waiting for that game puck. Yeah. Takes it down the hallway because he knew that a team down there has a broken heart after losing one of their team members in November. What a classy gesture. Well done, Plymouth South. Wow.